I'm Nitin Jain, Associate Professor in the Biochemistry, Cellular and Molecular Biology Department, and I teach a senior level biochemistry course, BCMB 401. In this class, I want my students to get out with a good understanding of biochemistry and then be able to use biochemistry on a good factual, conceptual basis in whatever they do in future. When I first started teaching this course, I noticed that students picked up concepts better when I used analogies in the classroom. We all often use analogies or metaphors to explain things. I designed a class activity where students review the analogy on a target concept as a group, then learn how parts of the analogy connect to various aspects of the concept. This helps students to see how processes in different areas are similar to each other philosophically, which enhances their understanding of the concept and stimulates learning in a peer-friendly group environment. Plus, they don't get bored while learning, since a lot of the analogies incorporate interesting and fun topics. After students have reviewed their analogies, they are given a different analogy on the same concept and then asked a list of questions that assesses them on their ability to find similarities to the target concept and then correctly assign factual information to various aspects of the concept. The students use responseware, such as clickers, to answer these questions. Initially, I would draw the analogies on the board or use hand-sketched analogies to illustrate the various concepts to students. But it'd be better if the analogy can be presented in a manner that appeals to the students and get them interested in working on them. So with the help of some wonderful folks at OIT, we are able to develop animations for some of the analogies that can be viewed by the students and also used to assess student learning. During my quest to develop more and more analogies, I soon realized that I can only come up with so many analogies myself. So I thought that after the group exercise, why not let students generate their own original analogies to describe the target concept and then use that as a part of their assessment. I set guidelines for them on how they can form analogies. What this led to next was just amazing. The students came up with really innovative and descriptive analogies. Soon we had a large database of student-generated analogies, some of which I now routinely use in my class after a bit of refinement and animation. At the end of the course, several students commented on how use of analogies contributed to their learning of the concepts. They found the animations illustrative and the correlation of various parts of the analogy with specific parts of the concept very helpful. What was even more striking was that some of the students applied the analogy-based methodology in subsequent classes such as BCMB 402, which enabled them to also do well in assignments in that class. One of my future goals is to upload the database of student-generated analogy descriptions and analogy animations onto a website so that students can review them during the course to learn about the various target concepts and see how others think about the same concept. Also, this will allow these analogies to be shared for use in other courses. My advice to instructors who want to develop this type of methodology is to go slow the first semester and think about a few main concepts you want your students to learn and develop analogies for those. Involve your students in the analogy development as well. Set guidelines so that the analogies developed are factually correct. Slowly build your database and share with other instructors and classes.